I'd like to begin the introduction of our two speakers here. Jeff Smith chairs the town's Underground Utility Task Force, the group of residents who have been appointed by the town council to help the town bury the overhead utility lines. Jeff is a longtime resident of Palm Beach and a highly respected architect in the community. He opened his office, Smith Agricultural Architectural Group, Inc., in 1989, and he served served the town as chairman of both the Architectural Commission and the Landmark Preservation Commission. As chairman of the town's task force, Jeff understands the importance of undergrounding. We've asked him to speak briefly today and to update us on the town's plan and the referendum. Please join me now in welcoming Jeff Smith.
Thank you, Bob, and thank everyone here. I really want to thank the Civic Association for their commitment to burying the power lines. So I'm considering this a very friendly group here. I don't think I have to beat this home. But as you know, the task force and the town council has already voted to underground utilities in the town. So we're really not voting for undergrounding utilities. We're voting for a bond issue. The bond is a $90 million bond to be paid back in 30 years. It's going to be divided into two tranches. Two $45 million tranches is what's expected now. The first tranche will be, because of IRS rules, we've got to do it that way because we only have 5 years to spend the money. So the first 5 years, we'll spend the first $45 million, and the second 5 years, we'll spend the other $45 million. The reason right now is an important time to do this is because if we don't do this, it's not that we get to keep the status quo. FPL is going to harden all the main trunk lines through the town. These are going to be taller, bigger, fatter, uglier, and since FPNL doesn't, if we go underground, FPNL will give us a 25% discount on the job. So now is the time to do it, and if the referendum doesn't pass, they will begin hardening these lines. There's been a lot of talk about undergrounding and that it's not as reliable as overhead. That's not true. Undergrounding is 80% more reliable than overhead lines. There's been a lot of talk about the boxes not being watertight or weatherproof. To begin with, all of our power lines that serve the town go under the intercoastal waterway. So we've had undergrounding since electricity has been brought to the island. Other naysayers say that the weatherproofing, every house that has been redone or built new since 1982 has underground service from the pole to their house. So undergrounding is not new here. It's the infrastructure that we need to underground. We're going to underground all the utilities. We're going to underground cable. We're going to underground the telephone. We're going to bring in fiber optics for faster communication lines. Nancy Brinker, sitting next to me today, was talking about she's already undergrounded because she lives in Phipps Estates. And she said, you know, people are talking about these ugly green boxes. They're only a low boy. They're 2 feet high, 3x3. And she said, but I have the biggest generator, and it goes on every day, and I've got to pay to maintain that. And once this town is undergrounded, you know, we can get rid of our generators. So I thought that was a very wise, and no one has said that to me yet. There's been a lot of talk about eminent domain. Interesting, I was on the selection committee for the engineering firms that have submitted to do the work. We shortlisted four engineering firms, and they come with a big team of lawyers and landscape architects and electrical engineers, and we asked each one of these each one of these engineering firms that have done work all over the state, all over the country, and asked them, what's the toughest problem? Have you ever used eminent domain to get an easement for these transformers? Not one had ever had to go to that task. So we felt that was very encouraging. Let's see if there's anything else I missed here. The vote is March 15th. This is going to improve aesthetics, reliability, safety. Everyone, I think, knows how it's being paid for, but you can go to the town's website, www.undergroundingpalmbeach.com, and you can type in your address, and it'll tell you how much your assessment will be. You can pay it all up front if you want. That number is also on the website.